Thank you. short leg. Also, as you can see, my hands are very oily. It's due to the lanolin in the wool. The wool is sent from here to a wool scourers where it's washed. The lanolin is extracted and then is used for perfumes or hand care products.
just looking out the window of the plane, you can't help but already be impressed. From a helicopter, it's breathtaking. And from a jet boat, well, it's all those things and just a little bit terrifying. Welcome to Queenstown, New Zealand, where you can do almost everything or absolutely nothing and love every single minute of it. Whether you want to power down a mountain or gaze in awe at one from below, anything's possible in this picturesque land of extremes. In the off chance the weather isn't perfect, the scenery always is, and there are a million ways to enjoy it, some less extreme than others.
Now, even if the weather itself hasn't been all that remarkable in Queenstown, sometimes it can be a blessing in disguise if you stay in somewhere like the Azua Hotel. With its open fireplaces, heated tile floors, massive hot tubs and incredible sweeping views, it's really not a bad way to spend a day in.
We would sort of coin it luxury accommodation but with a nice sort of homely atmosphere. So we want people to be sort of relaxed and comfortable, and we definitely try and promote sort of an informal environment.
It's now day two and I've decided to venture out of the hot tub and into the wild. We've booked an adventure tour on the Dart River and it starts early, real early. Like many on the bus, I consider more sleep, but the view out the window is just too good to miss.
Lake Waikato is actually New Zealand's longest lake, and from Glenorchy out this way, Gateway to Paradise, out and around to Kingston, is actually 81 kilometres. Just across from Queenstown there in the middle of the lake, it's 370 metres deep.
We transfer from the bus to a proud local product, the jet boat. Invented by a clever New Zealander in the 50s and piloted by a crazy one. The Dart River flows through rugged forested country in the southwestern part of New Zealand's South Island. As you hurtle past awe-inspiring snow-capped mountains, it's not hard to work out how these natural beauties became hotshot Hollywood stars.
You're a Lord of the Rings fan. If you saw the tower, and it always looked back into the misty mountains, the tower was digitally put down. You can see a green grassy sort of paddock right on the very flat area down through there. That's basically where the tower was digitally put, and you were looking back up into this valley all the time. You ever saw Wolverine? That's where Hugh Jackman ran naked out of the barn just in there. It was a warmer day than this.
If you want to carry on down the river at a slightly more civilised pace, you can transfer into a fun yak.
Guys, we've got 8 kilometres to do today, 4 kilometres, and then an hour for lunch or an hour or so for lunch, and then another 4 kilometres. Lots of food and hot drinks for you.
Proud Texan Grandma Joan later shared with me her inspiring adventure that began long before she put paddle to water.
This trip has been planned for more than 10 years. Back in the year 2003, I was a cancer patient. And during my cancer treatment, they gave me a very poor prognosis, but I didn't buy that. So I promised my granddaughter that when she was old enough, we would take a trip to Australia and New Zealand. And we arrived here 2 days ago. And today we had the adventure of a lifetime.
Queenstown's incredible natural beauty is almost otherworldly. But at just over 2 hours' flight from Sydney, it is absurdly accessible. But be warned, with all that's on offer year-round, a lot of people never seem to leave.
I think I'll do another winter. And then you think, well, I'll just stay for the summer, and then you don't want to miss out on the winter. So before you know it, a year has turned into 3 or 4, and then it's then hard to ever leave because it's one of only a few places in the world, I think, that can offer this sort of lifestyle of ski fields, mountain biking, hiking trails.
So what we'll do is this line we have a little bit further just to get away from the initial roll of the glacial sill, and then we'll turn around so we won't be able to.
Mm-hmm.